I'm very grateful to say that this dark night did not persist forever, and that as time went on, life took on a new centeredness, that life with the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit and life with others were no longer a different thing. And that God seemed in my life to be merging more and more my experience of His light and of His love and His presence with my daily service and walk with Him in the world. It seems now that many of the lights have ceased. And it's not that God is gone in the way I experienced Him before, but the revelations and the mystical experience, the transcendent knowledge and experience of God's glory and wonder has toned to a daily walk. I think that I find, as I'm growing now in deepening intimacy with God, that just serving with Him, walking with Him, and sharing His sufferings have become for me enough. That He's given me these blessings to encourage me into a place where all of life is simply life in Him. And that's the absolute joy of my heart to walk with Him into the places where He journeys. Knowing that my small life in my small place has been woven by Him into the tapestry of the coming of His kingdom. My prayer life is a quiet joy. And it seems like the silence and solitude of the prayer closet have expanded more and more in my life to include the people to whom God brings me. It seems like the enjoyment of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit are a dance into which He's invited me to participate and then to draw others to be loved and cared for and trusted there. I've finally come to realize that I don't have to make a difference. My life does not have to have significance. I no longer need meaning or purpose or worth, because Jesus has all those things. And He in me, and me in Him, are living out the most significant redemption of all creation. And that it's my utter joy to simply be lost in His love. Simply be lost in what He's doing. And if I were to die today, it matters not. If I'm to live to old age, it simply puts off the fullness of what I'm beginning to live into today. I'm learning to be self-forgetful. I think for most of my life, I've been concerned about my spiritual growth, about my spiritual formation. And I'm now realizing, as I live in this season of my life, that it's of no significance at all. That in Christ, my sin, my imperfection, my inabilities are dwarfed by His perfection, His purity, His love, and His ability. And I'm continually amazed and joyed at the invitation to simply walk with Him into the places, into the lives of people where He goes. Not really caring what it has to do with me. Life has become simply loving God the Father, loving God the Holy Spirit, and loving them in others.